Thank you, all of you.
For giving her what she deserved?
No, for being friends. When I was first sent here, well, I didn't realise I'd be meeting people like you.
Well, we're not about to sit by and watch you bullied around, especially by the likes of Kelly.
Watch where you're going, you stupid bitch.
I'll pull your head in. Don't want to get reported to the council again, do we?
Oh, you reckon you're the cat's whiskers now? Just because some trendy poofter bought a couple of your lousy T-shirts.
Yeah, tough luck your sabotage didn't work. You won't get another chance, will you?
Don't bank on it.
You touch my gear and your life won't be worth living. Every woman in this place is onto you.
God. So unfair. Why did she do this as Mrs. Davis? Didn't she realise how frustrating it would be to get something like this and be stuck in here? I mean, if I was outside, I'd be able to do something, but in here. But it's my mother, for God's sake.
You do want to see her then?
Well, of course I do.
I bet she'd be dead keen to find out about your old man. Get it? Dead keen.
Yeah, well, what do you mean?
What I mean? Your brother's dead. He's dead as a doornail. You killed him when you wrapped that car around a tree.
I know.
That's why your mum and dad wiped you. You murdered your own brother.
Oh, no. No! Oh, no, I did it!
Now I've heard it all. You pretending you didn't know your brother was dead. But you're dead keen, because you killed him in that crash as sure as if you had held a gun to his head. You see, I took the trouble to check up on you after you nearly killed my father. And it's not pretty, Kean. It's not pretty at all.
Oh, just leave me alone now, please.
In fact, your record makes Lizzie Borden's look very tame. Now, have you also forgotten about Phyllis Hunt?
Oh, who's she?
A vegetable, Kean, a vegetable. She didn't do what you wanted to do, so you smashed her skull in.
Oh, no.
Yeah, and what about your drugs, eh? Your little rackets. They killed Mitchell's baby and put Parker in the funny farm.
Oh, stop it!
Oh,
stop
there's
it!
More. I'm sorry, Kean, but there's more. It must be a great shock to suddenly realise that you're responsible for so many shattered lives.
Oh, no. Look, if I can only remember.
Now, if I had to face the awful truth about the things I'd done, I think I might kill myself. Perhaps that's the answer for you, Kean. Take your life to make up for all the terrible things you've
done. What the hell do you think you're up to, Ferguson?
Just helping a little mate through a trauma, Flynn.
You've got a strange idea of what helping is. You okay?
Well, there, you see. Kean, have a think about what I said, hmm?
You forget what that bitch says. Nothing you've done warrants taking your own life. Oh, yeah, maybe not, but Lou was right, you know. I did kill him. I'll kill my own brother, Nora. Oh, God! Now, listen to me. Okay, you were driving the car, but it was an accident.
He's dead, and I'm responsible.
You didn't do it on purpose.
Oh, yeah, well, maybe I did. Who knows? Miss Ferguson's telling me about people. Look at me, Nora. Look! People I've killed! I've killed people!
Now you stop that! Now you start living through that guilt in the state you're in and you'll be no good to anyone. Now if you want to make up the past, you've got to start making the future worthwhile.
Lovely. Lovely. It's ace, eh?
Oh, I'd be bloody insulted if a guy gave me a second-hand ring.
Oh, what?
I can only afford a decent one.
It's practically antique.
So?
Oh, what would you know, Kelly? All your tastes are in your mouth.
It's okay, Lou. I just like old things.
Oh. What if it turns you on?
I don't know why you bother trying to spare her feelings. She doesn't deserve it.
She doesn't have any.
What am I doing? Lexie's our star tonight. Congratulations, your last consignment was a knockout.
Oh, it went bad, eh?
They were fantastic and you know it.
Don't we all?
Yeah, well, it's speech time, okay? I'd just like to say that, well, without a little or a lot of help from inmates, I would have never got them to the front door. So thanks, everyone, for the great job you did.
We were beginning to think you'd forgotten us.
Oh, geez, no one could forget anything as ugly as you lot.
that all about?
Oh, it's a long story. I'm just glad it turned out so well.
I will take your word for it. Well, I'd better get busy. Oh,
can I talk to you, please?
Yeah, sure. What's up?
It's David Adams. You don't know if he's sick or anything, do you?
I haven't heard anything. Why?
Well, I haven't heard anything back. I've left messages, but nothing. Look, maybe he's decided not to take the case, but I need to know. It's driving me crazy not knowing.
Don't worry, Eve. I'm seeing Ben tonight. He'll know if anything's up.
Thank you.
Oh, Mrs. Morris, I've got a bit of a problem. I'm wondering if you could help me out.
Oh, yes, of course, if I can.
I've had a letter about my mother.
Your mother?
Yeah, it took me by surprise, too. Might be someone's idea of a joke, but I need to know.
Well, would you like me to make an appointment with a social worker?
No, there's no time. If I can believe the letter, it says she'll be out of the country the day after tomorrow. Look, I know it's one hell of a favour, but I was wondering if you could go and see her. She says she's a close friend. She'll know where to find her.
Well,
please. If it is her, we've got a lot of catching up to do.
Well, very well. I'll do what I can. Well, better tell me all about it.
Yeah.
Oh, Mervyn, you shouldn't be doing that.
I just want an excuse to see my Joyce.
Oh! Joan walked in right now.
We'll say that we've taken up ballroom dancing.
Oh! Oh! Dum, da, dum, da, dee, da, 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 da. Oh, look out! Oh, dear.
Oh, I think we should just stick to cooking.
Oh, I think you might be right. Oh, we are a good team, aren't we, love?
Oh, yes, we are, love. Oh, I haven't told you my surprise.
What?
The women want me to help judge their beauty contest, me.
And why not? I think that's terrific.
I've got this wonderful idea for a trip.
Oh. Hang on, love. Let me get rid of this phone. Hello, staff room. Yes, Andrea? Yes, put them through. Hello, Joyce Barry? Oh, no. No, I'll come right down. Thank you.
What's the matter? What's happened?
It's Norm. He's had a heart attack. I've got to get to the hospital, Mother.
There you are, love. Oh. I got here as soon as I could. How's Norm?
Oh, I don't know. They just told me to come down here and wait. Well,
no news is good news, they say.
Oh, you told Mrs. Reynolds?
Yes, love. She said for you not to worry about a thing. She let me get away early to be with you.
I'm sorry. I couldn't help overhearing you. Are you Norm's wife?
Yes.
I'm Beryl. I don't know whether Norm's told you about me or not, but,
Oh. Yes, Beryl. Oh, I'm sorry. This is Mervyn. Mervyn Pringle.
How'd you do?
Is there any news of Norm?
Not since I brought him in. It was awful. I wish that would... I hope you don't mind me getting the hospital to phone you at work, but he just kept asking for you all the time.
I'm glad you did, Beryl. I really am.
This may sound silly, but I thought you'd hate me.
Oh, whatever for. Norm's been so happy lately. That's the main thing.
Yes.
I know I hurt him when I left. I'm glad he's found someone like you.
Well, it didn't stop him talking about you all the time. You know he... I love him, Joyce. I really love him.
Oh, Beryl, please. He's got to pull through.
Excuse me.
Oh, it's Norm. Is he all right?
How is he? He's regained consciousness.
Oh, well, when can we see him?
Only one at a time, I'm afraid. He's asking for Joyce.
It's me.
Oh, come with me, please.
Don't worry. You'll be able to see him soon.
You know, I'm not surprised he keeps asking for Joyce. But it does hurt.
Yes, I suppose it does.
Poor Norm. He kept blaming himself when she left. He still loves her after all this time.
But he... Joyce said that he thinks the world of you.
He'll never marry me. You see, he just can't bring himself to get a divorce.
Doctors Wright and Brown, casualty, please.
Oh, hi. Sorry I'm late.
Oh. Oh, wait.
Oh,
surprise, surprise.
Hello there, would you like a drink?
In a minute.
Just talked him into being my best man.
Great.
Hardly had to twist his arm at all, did I?
I'm delighted.
That makes three of us. Ben, you'll have to excuse me for a minute. Where's Lou in this place?
That way.
Don't you go away, David. I promised Eve I'd find out where you've been hiding for the last couple of days.
I thought you said you'd been out there every day this week.
Yeah, well,
stretch the truth a bit. What's going on?
Oh, I think I'm the wrong man for the job. She'd be better off with someone like Bernie West handling it.
Now, come on, mate. Look, I've known you for too long.
Yeah. Okay. It's Eve. I've fallen for her. That's an understatement. I can't get her out of my mind. It's hardly the best state to be in if I've got to defend her properly.
How does she feel about it?
She doesn't know. And I'm not going to tell her. She's got enough to worry about.
Especially when a lawyer leaves her high and dry.
Yeah, well, I'll phone around first thing in the morning and see who's the best available to take over.
Now, hang on, mate. You've left that girl on tender hooks for days. If you really want to drop the case, you better get out there pronto and tell her what the hell's going on. It might take weeks to find another...
I know that. I'm sorry. Yeah, I will. I will go and see her.
That's it. I just can't do it, Nora.
Just a few lines saying the contest's on and there'll be prizes.
Yes, I know, but I can't concentrate. What if something's happened to Mrs. Barry and poor Mervyn rushing off like that even before dinner was finished? He looked as if his whole world had collapsed around.
Look, he probably just raced off to put some dough on the dogs or something.
Would not. He's not the type. No, there's been a terrible accident. I just know it.
There's no point worrying about it. If something has happened to Mrs. Barry, they won't be telling us till they're good and ready. Here, come on, I'll finish up the contest. You write the column.
Oh, it's tragic. They worship each other, you know, even more than John and Marsha on yesterday, today and tomorrow.
Look, can I go do this in my cell?
Please, yourself.
I can't help it if the trials of love affect me so deeply.
Yeah, I've heard it gets to a lot of you middle-aged virgins that way. What you need is...
Don't you dare!
What I was going to say is what you need's a good cry.
You were not.
Cut it out,
it's okay, I'm going.
Oh, good riddance. Now perhaps we'll get some work.
Oh, sorry, we're late.
Any news about Mr. Pringle and Mrs. Barry?
No.
Oh, did you write that Mr. P's going to be one of the judges for the beauty contest?
We'll wait till we get the whole panel.
Well, who else do you reckon?
Anybody but Hagen and the freak. Jeez, I couldn't stand them perving on us.
What about Mrs. Morris and the governor?
Oh, good one, yeah.
I'll ask them tomorrow.
Has anybody seen my notes?
Oh, sorry, Chooker picked them up. I thought I could pick up a few pointers. This is really good.
Finish it?
Just about.
Right. Listen to this, everyone. Who is Rebecca Kean? Not even Reb can answer this question after the treatment at Ingleside Park. A person who once walked over anybody who stood in her way now paces nervously as she tries to remember who and what she was.
Julie, that's perfectly brilliant.
Good intro, love, but it's got to go.
Why?
I'm sorry. It's got nothing to do with your writing. It's Reb I'm worried about.
But this is there to help her.
I just put about the change in her character and what caused it.
Yeah, and it's got some beaut stuff about what she did last time she was in here.
And that's why we can't use it. We're not going to help her by throwing her past at her all the time.
Well, that just leaves the human rights issue about the treatment they gave her.
I'm sorry.
No, it's all right. I know what you mean.
Well, I thought newspapers were there to report the facts.
We are, and we're sticking to our policy of helping, not hurting.
Here, here. It was awful. Oh, poor Noel. They wouldn't let me stay, Mer.
There, there, love.
It's not good news, is it? Another attack straight away like that.
Please, love, think of Beryl.
Oh, Beryl. Beryl, I'm sorry. It's all right. They're doing what they can. They promised.
Mrs. Barry?
Yes.
I'm very sorry. We try, but I'm afraid his heart was too weak to withstand the strain of the second attack.
I didn't even say goodbye. Oh,
thank you, Doctor. We were right. I'm sorry.
All right, Beryl, you will let us know, though, if you need anything. Good. Well, look after yourself. Bye. How is she?
Well, she seemed a bit better. Her mum came over.
Oh, girl. I suppose I'd better let our mates from the darts team know. We used to have some good times. Even made it to the state championships a few years back.
I know, love, you told me.
I wonder if Beryl would mind if I took those cups we both won.
I don't see why not. After all, you were his wife.
What's the matter?
Oh, nothing. Maybe it's just... I'm a bit worried that you'll let this get you down, losing someone you love and all.
I will miss him, Murph. After all, we did spend over half our lives together. But what I feel for Norm is really just fond memories of the good times we had.
These fond memories, is that why you wouldn't marry me?
Well, I...
You see, Beryl says that's why Norm wouldn't get a divorce. He still loved you.
Oh, I didn't know that. Oh, poor Norm.
Oh, bugger.
What?
Guess he's losing their touch. Hi. Guess you put their name down for the contest today.
You did?
Yep.
Oh, what are you going to wear?
Oh, what's it matter?
Well, you have to look nice.
What are you going to wear?
I'm not going in it. Don't be stupid.
Well, I got news for you. I put your name down today.
Well, you can just take it off again.
Oh, getting on it?
Why? You want me to make a fool of myself, is that it?
Oh, God, I give up.
Well, you know I wouldn't have a chance.
Oh, come on, it's just a bit of a lark. Even Lurch is going in and she's got a face like a squashed-in army boot.
I don't care. You can take it off first thing in the morning. You had no right.
You want your name off?
Yeah.
Well, you do it yourself. But everyone knows you're down for it. So I hope you can take the flak, chicken liver.
Oh!
Yes?
You must be Pringle.
I beg your pardon?
Where's Mum?
Oh, your gym. For a moment there, I thought we were being raided.
Got something to hide?
Oh, of course not.
Well, is she here or isn't she?
She's asleep, as a matter of fact. I wake her, but she only nodded off a couple of hours ago.
Go on, just leaving, weren't you?
Well, yes, of course.
Yeah, don't let me stop you.
Yes.
How could she leave Debra, a spineless prat like you?
Heavens, I'd be delighted.
Well, me too. And I bet Mervyn was thrilled to be asked.
He was. Sorry to hear about Mrs. Barry's husband. If you're talking to her, can you tell her the women send the condolences?
I will. Thank you, Nora. She'll appreciate it. And some good news. The department's given the go-ahead for the money for prizes.
Oh, great. We thought we'd buy some perfume for the winners and some chocolates.
Oh, well, I'll go shopping for them if you like.
Thanks.
Good.
Have you decided if we can wear our civvies? Make a big difference?
I think we can organise that if each entrant specifies which article she needs, then Mrs. Morris can arrange it.
Thanks.
Just remember, Nora, keep it within bounds.
Don't worry, we will.
Oh, Jim! Oh, you do look well. Queensland's obviously agreeing with you.
No complaints.
I didn't think you'd cut me down till after lunch, Ben.
Oh, well, no, there was a cancellation on the early bird flight, so...
Oh, Jim.
Something like that. It hit me hard, too.
Oh, he was too young. It's hard to believe he's gone.
Yeah.
Oh,
you know, I was just talking to him last week.
Oh, you were? Oh, I'm glad. We haven't seen much of you lately. I'm really pleased you kept in touch.
He'd been ringing pretty regularly since you left him, you know.
Oh, it's hard for me to explain why I left. But I did give it a lot of thought.
So you said. Didn't help Dad, though. I mean, he was really cut up.
Wasn't easy for either of us.
Didn't take you long to get mixed up with this Pringle bloke.
Jim.
I'm sorry, Mum, but it wasn't you on the phone all these months. Dad went through hell because of him.
How can you lay the blame at my feet like that?
Easy. I mean, it was bad enough that you left him, but the real kick in the teeth was taking up with a useless nitwit.
Now, that is enough. Mervyn is a wonderful man, and I love him just as much as I loved your father.
Look, he won't be... He could never be half the man Dad was. I'm glad I told him
you
so.
You said that to Mervyn?
Yes, I said that to Mervyn.
Oh, Jim. Look, I do understand your feelings about your father, but you're not being fair to Mervyn. He's been very, very good to me. And once you get to know him, I'm quite
Frankly,
sure you'll
Mom,
find...
I don't want to get to know him. Look, it's better if I just booked into a motel.
So I talked to Jan Coleman this morning on the telephone. She's tied up for about a week, but she's more than happy to take over the case.
Eve, what's the matter?
It's obvious, isn't it? You think I'm a cold-blooded murderer.
Eve, no, I could never think that. Don't you see why I can't take this case?
David...
Oh, look, I'm sorry. I really am sorry.
Don't say that. I don't know what I've been through waiting for you to get here. David, I can't stop thinking about you.
You're not thinking clearly at the moment, and I'm not helping matters either. I'm sorry.
I love you, David.
God, what's up Nora's nose lately? I mean, you can't say anything and she bites.
Well, you shouldn't keep saying awful things about Mrs. B's husband dying.
Oh, God. Well, we didn't even know him.
Yeah, but we know Mrs. B and it was her husband.
Ex. Anyway, I mean, everyone's got to cark it sooner or later. No point wearing a long face about it.
Yeah, well, if you'd ever lost someone you loved, you'd understand.
Probably never know then, eh? Hey, you taking your name off that list yet?
You'd really love me to do that, wouldn't you? Just so you can give me a hard time.
Oh, you bet. What's life if you can't have a bit of a stir, eh?
Well, I'm really sorry to disappoint you, but everybody else is going in it, so am I.
Hey, Chook's no chicken after all.
Oh, I wish I had your confidence.
I've got a good lawyer.
I don't mean just that. I was comparing myself to you. I was a spineless piece of jelly when I first came in here.
You were rather sheltered by your grandmother.
Oh, I didn't realise how much until they threw me into prison. Ludicrous, isn't it? I've got more freedom in here than I ever had at home.
Oh, Jen, I don't know how you stood it. I'd have walked under a bus. I was used to it. Well, after my parents died anyway. Oh, when I was little, we were always doing something or going somewhere.
Do you remember much about them?
Not really. Oh, but Eve, I was so in love. Oh, it was wonderful just to sit and watch them.
Yeah, well, there we've got something in common. I learned a lot by watching my parents. I learned my mother could get anything she wanted just by promising an extra special time between the sheets.
Oh, Jen, don't look so shocked. Surely you know the power we wield with our bodies?
Well, I guess I don't. I'm one of those rare commodities who hasn't tried it yet.
Oh, Jen!
I haven't even had a boyfriend.
Oh, well, then, there are things you need to know if you're going to come out on top when you leave this place. Oh,
I'll be okay now. I mean, I've learnt to stand on my own two feet in here.
No, I'm talking about men. They still hold all the cards, believe me.
Oh, Eve, I don't really believe that. I mean, well, look at Pippa, for instance. I mean, she's totally in control of her life. Marrying Ben isn't going to change that.
No way. She'll be trading her body for a home and her clothes. Marriage sounds like prostitution.
Well, isn't it? If you learn to do it well enough, you don't need the ties of matrimony. I did quite nicely out of Robin.
Oh, but I thought you loved him.
Of course I did.
I hate to get on the wrong side of you today. That was probably the most savage game I've played.
Which is going to cost you the biggest beer in town.
Laugh while you can, my learned friend. The next time, the forfeit will be yours. You know, you've certainly taken on a tough case, David.
Oh, maybe. But we'll win, I'm sure of it.
Surprises me you dropped the case, actually. Do you mind telling me why?
Many reasons. The main one being there's a chance I might win.
What?
Oh, don't get off your horse.
What do you expect, making a statement like that?
Look, I knew Robin Sanderson well, and I saw the effect that Eve had on him over the years.
Eve had? Oh, come on. The guy had money troubles, his wife walked out on him.
Ah, they were in recent events, Dave. And I'm not blaming Eve for it all either, hell no. Believe me, Robin was the problem. He was so besotted with a woman, he couldn't think straight when she was around. Had to have an effect on his professional life. Anyway, it took him a while, but when Helen finally left him, he realized he had to pull himself together. Make a break with Eve or lose everything.
What are you saying?
Not accusing her of anything, but the fact is, Robin was leaving her and now he's dead. And Eve's story has a hole in it a mile wide.
She didn't do it, Adrian. I'd stake my career on it.
Maybe she did, maybe she didn't. But I owed it to Robin to stay right out of it while the doubt exists.
It's your shout.
Sure. We'll sink a few for luck. You're going to need it, David.
I don't take on cases expecting them to be simple.
Not the case, the woman. She's got you, hasn't she? Just be careful. Remember what I said about Robin and what happened to him.
Hi.
Hi.
Oh, I'm really glad you came. I've been busting to see you.
Yeah, what's the big excitement?
Your engagement. We've all seen the ring. And Lexie reckon Pippa's real stoked about it.
Well, I would have bought it weeks ago for if I'd known it was going to have that effect.
You know what I mean. It's not the ring. It's just, well, we can all see how much she loves you, and I think that's really nice.
Thanks, Daphne. Me too. In fact, I might stick to my promise and marry the girl.
Oh, stop joking about it.
I'm sorry. Sit down, Daphne. No need to worry. I'm just as stoked as Pippa is. And now it's time for your big news.
What?
Your appeal starts tomorrow.
Oh, you're kidding. That's too soon. I'm not ready for
it. There's nothing to worry about. First few days, you won't even need to be in court.
Yeah?
Yep, true blue.
Well, how long after that will we know if it's going to do any good?
Well, it could take several weeks. It's hard to say.
Oh, God.
I wouldn't let it get you down. I'm just as certain as I ever could be that at the end of it all, you'll be waving goodbye to Wentworth.
Hey, come to the rec room.
In a minute.
I got something to put to you first.
Like what?
Well, I've worked out a way for you to get back at those narcs. But there's a profit in it for you somewhere.
Why not?
50-50 if you give me a hand.
Yeah? What do you have in mind?
Well, I thought we might start a book on this contest they're all crowing about.
Oh, yeah. I put my name down. Oh. Can't see how we'll make much, though. Everyone will go for the good-looking ones.
Well, they'll get scratched before the judging.
Eh?
Who do you reckon stands a chance of winning?
Well, Wilder's not joining in, so I reckon Patterson, Hartley, maybe.
So we cut down the odds and get rid of them.
Oh, no way. I've already got the blame for your snuff and Sam Greenway. I'm not getting mixed up in it, bugger ya.
We're not going to kill the bitches. Hell, Alice.
Well, then what then?
We just snap a couple of bones and bruise a few faces, you know.
Oh, yeah, that's okay then. Jeez, can't lose, eh?
Down the corridor. What's the panic?
I'm sick of all the stuffing round we do. We're lucky if we get any time to do any work.
Here's the paper to hold things up a bit more. Julie, your big feature. Julie's done a great article on your treatment of the Ingleside. You want to see it?
Oh, it's okay. She let me read her notes. I wish there was some way I could get back at those bastards for what they did to me.
Glad to hear it.
Look, I was pretty negative last night, wasn't I? Well, it's okay. You were right. You get nowhere feeling guilty all the time. You're pretty stupid when you can't remember what you did to start it in the first place.
Good for you. And if you start getting down again, you come and talk to me about it, okay? No point bottling it up.
No worries.
Hey, guess what, everyone? My appeal starts tomorrow. Daphne, that's great. I wish I could be there and see you and Mr. Fulbright in action.
I wish everybody could be there.
You're going to be there, Pippa, to see him stick it up them buggers?
You just try and stop.
Oh, that'd be terrific. That'd be real good.
Okay, everyone, who needs a hand with their projects today?
Oh, well, I'm okay as long as these buggers don't get stuffing me up.
May as well go home. Oh, is that the new issue?
Hot off the press. Take a look at Julie's article.
Thank you.
Yes, she's done, I reckon.
Hey, you're pretty chirpy, aren't you? I thought you'd pay yourself when the big day came.
Oh, no. Mr. Fulbright told me everything's going to happen, see? And it's all going to be a breeze.
You'll be the star of the show, Daphne.
Yeah, well, I'm glad it's you and not me. I couldn't stand sitting there while they discuss me off days.
Lexie?
Oh, no, it's all right, Nora. See, it doesn't worry me anymore. Like Mr. Fulbright says, it's only natural.
This is outrageous. 27 times. Yeah. Is this true? Can you back this up?
We got the info from a screw, along with what Reb can remember about it.
It's barbaric. God, Reb, it's a wonder you're still okay. Do you mind if I take this home?
Go ahead.
Thank you. Great piece of journalism, Julie. I'm sure a lot of people are going to be very interested to read this.
Yes?
I'm looking for a Mrs. Davis, the person who wrote this letter to Nora Flynn. It's about her mother?
Yes, I know. I wrote it.
Oh, good. Oh, I'm sorry. I should have introduced myself. I'm Meg Morris from the Wentworth Detention Centre.
What can I do for you?
Well, Nora was very grateful for you contacting her. But the thing is, she'd very much like to see her mother before she leaves the country.
I'm afraid that's impossible. Mrs. Gibson is dead. She died 2 weeks ago.
But your letter?
I merely tried to spare the woman's feelings.
But I don't understand. I mean, Nora hasn't heard of her mother for over 30 years, and now you write saying she's alive when there's absolutely no hope of Nora ever seeing her.
I thought it was best at the time. Mrs. Gibson begged me before she died to tell Nora how much she regretted what had happened, to try and make amends in some way.
I see.
I do hope the letter helped in some small way to atone for any rejection she may have felt over the years.
She was so keen to make contact. Look, would it be asking too much for you to go and visit her at Wentworth? I'm sure it would help. Well, just to talk to someone who'd been close to her mother for all these years, or filling the gaps in her own life.
Yes, I suppose it would help.
Then you'll come?
All right, I will. For her sake.
I'll tell her. We can organise a time. Thank you very much.
Bye.
Bye.
Amelia, who was that?
Nobody important, Mrs. Gibson. Yes, in a moment.
Has Pippa gone?
Just missed her.
I'll help.
Oh,
hey,
thanks.
Can you give us a few pointers on how to do the face lighter?
I'd be glad to.
Oh, you're already doing real good, Lexie. I'm the one who needs the help.
It's you that said it, not me. Come on, only joking.
You've got very good bone structure, Daphne.
You reckon?
Would you like me to show you how to bring it out to its best advantage?
Oh, that'd be great. Hey, come on, Lex, we've got to get this off it in case the others want to play pool.
Oh, the buggers can wait until we're finished, huh? Everyone's very excited about the beauty competition.
Mm, in here, if it's different, it's exciting.
You know what you mean. I've been here a few days and I'm bored out of my mind. God, I won't.
Oh, well, come up with a Mona Lisa through this afternoon.
What?
You can be so crass sometimes.
It's a statue, isn't it?
No, dear, it's a famous painting, one that should be appreciated, not joked about.
I'm just trying to encourage a little classicism, madam.
Oh, classicism.
Oh, that looks interesting, love. What is it?
Oh, well, it's just a house with a beach near it. We used
to... Ah! Oh, God, oh, what's mommy? Wrong? Some inconsiderate person has left a mess in that chair.
Oh, it's only water.
Are you sure you didn't you know what?
Oh, that's all you ever do, isn't it? Make fun of me.
Me?
Yes, you're cruel and heartless, Meg.
Oh, Willie, someone just spilled it during art class.
Tell May Collins I will not speak to her again until she apologises to me in person.
Oh. I'll go and lend her my hairdryer.
Well, here we go again.
Oh, hey, Auntie May, have you ever seen the real Mona Lisa?
Well, as a matter of fact, I have. I mean, that charlatan lover of mine took me to Paris once and we popped over to the Louvre to see it.
The Louvre?
The Louvre. The R is silent.
Hey, what's it like, this Mona?
Well, it's much smaller than I thought, but it's pretty amazing. Hey, that reminds me, love, that article you wrote was terrific.
Mm. Oh, thanks, Auntie May.
Yeah, Pippa thought so too, didn't she? She took a copy home with her.
Really? I wonder if she'll do anything about it.
Possible. Seemed pretty fired up about it.
Might be a bit more cautious when she cools down, especially after that PMS article.
Could try getting it to the papers ourselves, I suppose.
Oh, you'll be famous, Jules. Oh, Rev would, not me.
How would we get it out, though?
I could give it to me mum.
Your mum? Do you think she would?
Yeah, if I asked her. And I'd be real careful. I wouldn't show it to any of the screws or anything like that.
What do you think?
Well, it's worth a try. For Rev's sake.
Would you believe a white flag?
Oh, come on, Willie. It was just a joke.
And you won't mind apologising, will you?
All right, I'm sorry. What exactly are you doing?
I'm making a face pack. And don't you dare say a word about it, May Collins, or I'll never speak to you again. I mean it this time.
I wouldn't think of it. Mad, is it?
Yes, Daphne got it for me. I read it contains excellent qualities for cleansing and toning.
You sure it's the right sort?
Well, it's mad, isn't it?
Oh, yes.
Yes. I added some face cream to bind it together, and if it works as well as I think it will, it'll do a wonderful trade.
Yes, well, have you decided what you're going to wear yet?
Yes, my good suit and pink angora sweater.
That's a bit out of date, isn't it?
Suits are never outdated.
Well, styles have changed a bit, love. Look, why don't you wear that nice mauve frock?
You'd love that, wouldn't you?
What?
You know that frock makes my skin look yellow.
Oh, it does not.
It does so. You're deliberately trying to sabotage my chances.
Gord, I apologise. What do you want, blood?
You don't fool me. I know your underhanded tactics. Purple frock, indeed. The very idea.
Doesn't bloody matter what colour you wear. You haven't got a hope in hell of winning anyway.
Don't you swear at me.
Oh, dear, excuse me. I forgot. Butter wouldn't melt in your mouth, would it? Well, good luck.
Jen?
Oh, no, come in.
I've got a favour to ask. Except you might think I'm stupid.
Try.
Would you mind plucking the eyebrows for me? See, I've never done it before. Would you?
All right, when?
Ta-da! Eve lent them to me.
Come on.
Oh, thanks.
Right. Now, you've got to let me know if I hurt you, all right?
Oh, no worries.
Hey, have you decided which bit you're going to play for the contest yet?
No. Oh, sorry.
Oh, it's all right. Didn't hurt. I thought I might play that Moonlight Sonata one, you know, except I'm going to need a bit more practice.
I'll go over it with you after, if you like.
Oh, that'd be great. Except don't you worry, I won't get so good that I beat you or anything.
Oh, Daphne, don't be silly.
Careful, Jen. You nearly poked me eye out.
Sorry. I mean, heavens, I don't think about winning. I don't think many of the others do either. I mean, it's just for fun.
I know that. Why else do you think I'm doing it? You're still going to win, though.
You never give up, do you?
Oh, it's all right, dear. It's just me.
Willie?
Yes.
Willie, you've run the life out of us.
I'm sorry, dear. I just wanted to ask you... Oh, no, it's all falling off. How long do I keep it on?
What is it?
A face pack. Oh, no, it's ruined.
Is that what you wanted all that dirt for?
Yes, of course it was. I'm looking at it. Why'd you make me talk, for goodness sake?
Oh, yum. Honey, it's dinner.
I do. I'm starving. You ready?
Yeah, almost. Grab a drink.
Okay.
Oh, Ben, read this. It's unbelievable.
What is it?
Read it. People seem to think prisoners have no rights whatsoever. Excuse me. So, what do you think?
That's incredible. Do they contact the family at all?
There's just her mother, but she's overseas. Look, Reb's a comprehending human being. How dare they treat her like some laboratory animal?
It could all be exaggerated. I mean, are you sure of the facts? I mean, it's just not possible.
It's no exaggeration. And it's very possible Anne had a report from Ingleside.
Well, if they've admitted to this, then God knows what they've subjected Kean to that they're keeping under wraps now.
My thoughts exactly. Look, she's still fairly agitated, so you'll have to go easy with her.
Hey, now, hang on a minute. If you think I'm going to take that on as well, I'm sorry.
Why not? She needs someone backing her.
Pippa, I am not the only lawyer in town. I've got more than enough on my plate as it is.
You've only got the Daphne Graham case.
Which is going to take all my concentration if we're going to win. Now, I'm not going to compromise that.
Fair enough, but at least you could start the ball rolling on this one.
No, I am sorry. I'm certainly not going to go leaping in over Anne's head on this. Now, she's the governor of the prison. Now, it's up to her to take up the issues before you, me, or anybody else goes barging in.
Ben!
You have to learn to stop getting involved in things that are none of your business.
Nora? Did you find her?
No, but I spoke to the woman who wrote the letter.
She hasn't left. She's coming to see me.
Sorry, Nora. Your mother died 2 weeks ago. Mrs. Davis just didn't want to upset you. But she is coming to see you and is going to help you with anything you want to know. Nora.
I'm okay. Thanks for going to all that trouble.
Do you want me to get May to keep you company?
No, I'll be all right. I mean, I didn't really know her, did I?
If you want to speak to someone, I'll be available.
Okay.
Jeez, you're getting boring, Kelly. Rack off.
So's her amnesia act.
Don't you ever let up.
Is she getting heavy with you now? Oh, she's just annoying. What's the joke?
Willie, he's mad back. I wish you'd seen
him. Oh, I can't say anything when she comes in. I mean, she's so upset.
I can't wait.
Oh, don't, honey, mate. Not after she sat in the water, too.
And that's right. Oh, what a lovely day it's been.
Well, look, speak of the devil. What a glowing complexion you have, madam. You must let me borrow some of your famous cosmetics.
You gave yourself a beauty treatment, eh, Willie?
I was going to show you what they've written about your T-shirts in the paper.
Oh, yeah, what?
No, I changed my mind. You can have it when I'm good
and clean. Oh, come on, Willie.
Don't be a bloody spoil sport.
Give it back.
Manners. Hey, sorry. Interrupt your legs.
What's the laser? Get out of my light. I don't believe this. This is me mum.
Hey, Lexie's mum's in the paper.
Where? Show us, love.
Don't lie, Lexie. That's Lord and Lady Brookinnings. I read it myself.
But it is, I tell you. That's the old codger she ran off with. Bloody hell, she's hit the jackpot.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside. And things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing